All right, this is a brief video on how to make a video with a really cool little tool called Adobe Express. It's free. You go to adobe.com/express, create video, and you will find it here. The first thing you do is hit on the Start Now button. It would normally ask you to log in here. But I was recently logged in and it doesn't make me log in again. So I am going to type in my title. This just helps create my file title when I download. So you can put anything in there or nothing. It'll give you a title. For my students that are doing this for their final project and creating a slideshow, you are not going to use these templates, but you're going to start from scratch down here. And you can see this is a relatively rapid kind of a thing. So the first thing that I want to bring out to your attention is there are different layouts. So there's a full screen kind of a layout, split screen, let's see if it'll show you. So there's places to add stuff, a caption, different things. I'm choosing title and text because my students need to have a title page. I'm just gonna type that in here and then I'll show you the different options. So for my students, I want you to have something that is not in competition with black and white images and storytelling. So I suggest like this theme, but one of the probably not too much color. Well, that's not bad, but I prefer, I'm creating a black and white story, black and white images. You can see there's different options here. This isn't bad. Black is always a lovely choice with black and white images. But I'm gonna, for this example, just to go up here to this standard. I kind of like this nice clean black and white look. I don't want you to use resize because that makes it square is the only option. So I want you to stick with widescreen. And music we will choose at the end when we have a sense of what we want. Screen, oh, layout. I guess it doesn't really matter what's over there. I want you to see the time for each of my students. Times I want it to be about 10 seconds. It didn't want to go up to 10, so I just left it at 9. I need to be able to look at these things for a fair amount of time, and so do your classmates. And a three or four second slide is very, very brief. I can add slides down here, so I just hit the plus button. I can add all kinds of things. So if you're not my student, there's all kinds of options. You could add a little video or a text, or as my students are going to do, they are going to add their own photos. So in preparation, I'm going to come over here to upload. In preparation, I put my 5 photos for my story in a folder together in chronological order to make things easier. When Adobe Express pulls something into this to make it a video, it expands the photograph, so it crops it, and I don't want my students to let Adobe crop their images. So this is a little editing button, and that we're going to zoom out until we see the whole image. Now here I saw there's not really, I don't think, any cropping. No, it is cropping a little. Okay, no cropping. That is the rule. So now I've got my first image here. I need to remember to put the time slide, my little booger. There we are. And then another slide for my next photo. You're gonna see it really is pretty fast putting together a video here. Oh, look, I can do this while it's, no, I can't. It doesn't want to think and chew gum at the same time. So I can, now that it's uploaded, I can increase the time. I have to remember to zoom out so that I see my whole image. And I'm ready to put my next slide in here. You can see down here, I can slide this to see my different slides. This is where I'm at. I'm going to put a photo in here. This is photo number 3 in my storytelling sequence. I have to wait a little bit. And then zoom out so I can see my whole photo, put my time up there around 10 seconds, add another one. Well, let's start with the time first this time, since I'm thinking about it. Photo, upload, photo number 4. And if I forget, look, down there's the last one. I know to just go here. So this particular story, in case you're wondering, is, I called it creation story because it is the story of creating a piece of artwork. And, okay, I can slide this over. I have one more photo to add to my 5-story sequence. Patiently waiting for it to fully upload. Editing, just zooming out on my photo. So all of it's there. Time, bring that up to 9 or 10 seconds. And then my last slide is my credit page, so my students have to do. So I'm just putting my title here again. And then in this, so it's created with work by Judith Monroe. And for my students, if you have a model in it, and I sort of have a model in mine, you need to give your model credit here as well. And Frozen Charlotte is the doll's name that I took a photo of that I made artwork from. So and then now I can go to music. I can choose some kind of music. I don't know what this sounds like. I can listen to it. Oh, here, let's play it and it'll tell me what it sounds like. Okay, I don't know if you can hear that or not, but we'll call that good. So I've added this music to the whole thing, and I can either play my I'd have to put it at the very front and play it, so I can play my whole video. Or I can tap through it. And because you don't want to watch this play over and over. But if I were doing this for me, I would absolutely sit here and watch it. But this is a way for me to check it. And then when I'm finished, then I can hit the download button. And this is going to take a little bit of time, a couple of minutes, so I'm going to pause the video so you don't have to watch the little turning wheels with me. Hey, and I don't know, that might have taken a minute or so, not too long. So now I just, you can see my video file story, creation story, MP4 can now be downloaded. I hit the download, there it goes, and I'm done. So that's how you make a video slideshow with Adobe Express, and pretty cool, pretty easy. Thank you.